went to college, I was kind of double track. I was a political science major, that's why I went to school in DC. Then I was kind of in the public relations end of things. And so I worked in a law office and I worked in a PR firm. So I could figure out, and that's kind of part of my, that's how I do things. I don't, generally speaking, do things irrationally. I'm very like focused and rational. I said, so let me see what each of those worlds were like. And so I worked at a couple different firms when I was in college, just filing papers, delivering things, and just really reinforced the fact that I really wanted to go to law school. Working class parents, mother, stay-at-home mom, dad worked the night shift at Budweiser. My grandmother, though, my father's mother always worked. She was an immigrant, first generation, so she was a worker. So they didn't go to college, they weren't in careers. So really, as far as I was concerned, I was branching out significantly from what their life experience was. My law school class was like, if it wasn't 50-50, it was close. And I think 10 years before that would not have been like that. So when I got there, the culture had already, in terms of law school at least, shifted. And I never felt, because there were so many women in my class, and I went to night school initially and then switched over, I never felt that I was anything other than equal to my law school peers. By the time I got to law school, things had progressed a lot in a very short period of time. It's like Virginia Long, who was on the Supreme Court forever, sat in this county, Miriam Spann, Barbara Wecker. You know, you'd look at these women and they were the ones who would be like five people in a class of 200 and have to put up with a lot.
What advice, if any, would you give young women interested in a career in law?
A few things. First of all, they should really find a good mentor that can help them navigate a lot of things that you have to do. The law is very demanding, some parts of it less so than others, but you need somebody who's kind of been there, done that, can help you through all of those stormy seas. So I think that's one of the things now that I would like to encourage women to do, is don't just say, it's hard, I was there, it was very hard. But I think when you put that robe on for the first time and you're sitting there and people are in front of you who you are now making decisions that are going to impact them for the rest of their lives, there's something, you know, that just causes you to take a deep breath and recognize how important what you do each and every day is.